Idea of today's webinar is segment routing. So once again, I welcome everyone for this webinar. Today I'm going to be focused on this segment routing deployment use cases. So before we're going to be start, let's take a look about what is the today's agenda and what are the topics I am going to be cover within the next 1 hour. So this is about me. So as I mentioned that currently I'm associated with Coining Solutions and primarily focus on routing, switching and data center, where the prime focus is on towards SDN technologies. Like, of course, Cisco is offering different flavors of SDN for enterprise environments, and of course, as well as for the service provider environments, where in enterprise environments, SDN solutions like we have SD-WAN, SD-Access, and of course, ACI. So I'm taking care of all these SDN solutions along with service provider technologies as well. So today's agenda is to explain about segment routing. So here is the list, which is what I'm going to be cover here. So first in the task one, I will focus on this segment routing overview, that what is segment routing, what is the concept of segments, what problem this is going to be solved. And then we will see that where is segment routing is we are using. And then there is, we'll understand in more details what is exactly this segment is. And then finally, we will see that deployment. So I will also demonstrate quick verification commands with the help of topology as well. So that is the agenda for today's program. So first section is talking about segment routing. So segment routing here is also known as source routing, where notice this is the technology is used in service provider environments, where service providers currently is using, of course, MPLS is the major technology. MPLS, multi-protocol label switching, which means MPLS is my label forwarding technology. And in order to build label tables, of course, MPLS is also using additional label distribution protocols. For example, we have LDP we are using to allocate a label for IPv4, IGP learn IPv4 prefixes. We are also using label this protocol RSBP, which is we are using for MPLS tunnel-based technologies. So here, the idea of this segment routing is that retain the MPLS functionality, which means I still want label forwarding, because label forwarding idea is that how I can make my service provider core BGP free. I mean, customer routes, we are not going to be installed in core of the SP network. So same flavor I want, I mean, label forwarding functionality. But then in order to provide that label forwarding functionalities, I'm not going to be use this LDP protocols. There is no requirement of RSVP. But the same benefits, whatever the benefit is we are getting from this LDP and RSVP, the same benefits we are going to be take with this concept called segment routing without any additional overhead of control plane protocol. So as this name mentioned, this is also source-based routing, where once the packet is arrived in my, so in my provider edge, so we have, there is a provider edge router. This is the edge router from where I'm going to receive packets from customer network, which means the moment packet is arrived, now this router is going to be now inject or giving instructions about that, how I'm going to be forward this packet into service provider cloud using this label forwarding mechanisms. So in simple words, segment routing is the, we can say, advanced version of MPLS technology, where additional overhead of LDP and RSVP is not required, because notice when we're going to be build our service provider network. So in a service provider network is look like this, where we have this is my, let's say, MPLS cloud here, where we have the provider edge router, we have the P routers, we have number of P router, which is my core routers, and then of course on the other side we have also another provider edge router. So this is my service provider terminology, where of course, in order to provide reachability from provider edge 1 to provider edge 2, what I need to be, of course, configure IPv4 addresses, and over that we are using any IGP protocols. So we have two options, I mean two choices here to run in my SP network as a IGP list. So we can go for OSPF. Of course, we have to be an OSPF before I'm going to enable the MPLS technology. And of course, the second choice, we have also ISIs. So that is the protocol, is the, these are the two protocol is prerequisite before I can take the advantage of MPLS technology. And over that, over these protocols now, additional protocol is required, which is helping me to build a labeled database. Now, when I am going to be use segment routing, which means additional control plane protocol is not required, like LDP and RSVP. So which means functionality which is be required to generate label, that functionality is injected in this IGP based protocols, that is of course OSPF, ISIS, and on my edge routers, on edge to edge, we are using another protocol which is MPBGP, which means segment routing functionality is also injected in BGP protocol as well. So notice segment routing is my source routing, where once the packet arrive, there is a terminology called this provider edge. So this provider edge router is also known as head end router. So this is the head end router, which means once the packet arrive, it need to be impose label for that destination based packets. And then based on those instructions, core network is just follow the that execution, which is the information is injected by that head end router, which is of course in service provider network is known as provider edge. Okay, so now here, segment means is anything which is notice instructions that instructions which is we giving to our head end router based on that intent based logic or intent based informations we are putting on my head end routers. We are simply instructions we are giving that if I want to go for a particular node, then go through that P1 or P2 and then go for that final destinations. So that is the instructions we are encoded in my that labeled packet. And then of course service provider core router is just following the instructions given by provider edge. So segment routing here simply is also known as label based routing, which means it is a still MPLS based technology. Difference is that I'm not going to be use LDP and RSVP in order to fulfill the label of forwarding or label that generation concepts. Now here, more specifically, segment we can categorize into two main type. So segment is categorized in two category. One is known as your global segments. Notice global segment is globally unique in the SP core, which means each node in your service provider network, that is we are going to be recognized with this global segment. So the way I'm going to be identify each node, That is, with the help of global segments, each node in the segment routing domain is installing that instructions in the forwarding tables. Notice there is also a reserve range we are using, which is going to be start from 16,000 value, where the possible number of labels we have, total size is 8,000, like that. So global range. So recommended is that do not change this global block range for segment routing allocation for that global segment, which is also known as prefix. So global segment is also known as your prefix segments, which is the way we're going to be assigned this. So on each node, we are assigning this prefix segments on our loopback interface, like that. So the second type of label we have, that is local segment. Now notice global segment, we have to be manually configure. So manually, the number is given by administrator on each node. And then local segment is similar to that traditionally how LDP is going to generate label for that transit prefixes. So local segment is similar to that traditional label, which is local to link. And that is originating nodes are able to interpret that, where MPLS is going to be allocate this label locally. So this is automatically generated a label, but in case of global, that is, we have to be configured manually. So if you see this more precisely about that, how I'm going to be advertise this label informations, again, when I'm going to be, of course, deal in service provider technology. So we need mechanisms that how I'm going to be allocate this label from one router to another, which means notice here, we are going to be use IGP protocols, and in service provider, we have the two main choice. Either we can go with OSPF, and the second choice we have ISIs. So of course, either one we can pick. So segment information, which is your label. So segment simply meaning is label, and that label information is injected in this IGP protocols, which means I as administrator is going to be enable one more instructions just in the ongoing IGP protocols. And then information, which is the two labels we have seen, global label and local label. Notice global label is also known as with this name prefix segments. That is, of course, the way I'm going to advertise that label, either with the help of ISIs or we can use OSPF as well, where again, adjacency segment, which is your local segment, automatically generated. Notice local segment advertised as a label value. And again, the way I'm going to distribute it, this is ISIs and OSPF. So simple logic. There is no requirement of LDP and RSVP as an additional control plane overhead, but I still want label forwarding technology, which means so far there is no replacement of MPLS. So we are not replacing MPLS technology. MPLS technology remains the same, because function of MPLS technology is to provide label forwarding, and the same functionality we are providing now with this new concept called segment routing. Okay, so now here, so far we understand there is a two types of segment we have. One is global and second one is your local label. Global label is known as with this name prefix segment ID, and then local label is known as with that name adjacency segment ID. Notice this is the default range of a label, and it is recommended do not change this range. And if I'm going to be change it, so then I need to make sure that, for example, here we have router 1, router number 2, router number 3, and router 4. So default range on each node is is following this value 16,000 to 23,999, which means when I'm going to be assigned label, global label. So what I will do here, of course, first I need to configure loopback interface. So let's say I'm giving the IP number here 1.1.1.1 as a host route like that. And after that, of course, we are running any routing protocols, which means any routing protocol, which means we have only two choices. For example, I'm using ISIS. So router ISIS, router ISIS with the process ID. Within this, of course, we will go for that particular interface number, interface loopback 0. And then the way I'm going to be configure our global segments, I will give the information that prefix segment ID. And then notice we have two information here. I can set the absolute value, but then the absolute value should be from this range, like this range, or I can also use the index system, for example, here. So I need to make sure that each node, so this is my, say, provider edge 1, this is my P1, that is my P2, that is my provider edge 2. So just need to make sure that each node is using the unique global value. So in this case, for example, for router 1, which is provider edge 1, I want to, let's say, using the index number 1, which means what this router will do, this is taking this base value, which is 16,000, and then going to be add whatever the index I have set, which means 16,000 plus 1. So global label for this global label for that router 1 is 16,001. Now, benefit of using the same label range in all the router is this is going to be simplify, of course, troubleshooting, verification, logic. And of course, later on, when we going to be implement advanced policies like traffic engineering, so then that is also that traffic engineering configuration is also simplified, because we know that for each router, there is a unique label, and that all the, for example, here, let's say I have, this is the label is allocated by R1. So of course, 1.1.1 prefix is also available here. 1.1.1 prefix also is here. 1.1 is also here. That is learned using that OSPF or ISIS protocols, which means because all the router is using, so this router is going to be advertised that label value. So we will see that router 2 is also using same label for this prefix. Router 3 is also going to be used same label for that prefix. And of course, router 4 is also using same label for that prefix, which is originally generated by that router 1. So although we can change it, but then again, when I'm going to be change this segment routing global range, so then make sure that all of the routers, in that case we have to make changes in all the routers so that we can provide uniform policy as I discussed earlier. So prefix segment ID is must defined by administrator manually, and notice this must be your domain wide unique value, which means in this case, what I will do for prefixes, which is, let's say here I have prefixes on router number 2. So what I will do simply, I will set the index number 2 for this. For that one, I will set index number 3 for this. And for this loopback prefixes, I will set index number 4. So 4 meaning, so I have the prefix number here 440. So what is the global label for that 444? It will be your 16,004, like that. So global label, and this label is advertised by which protocols? Either I can use ISIS or I can use OSPF. Two choices in my service provider core. Okay, so here is example is given. Notice index number is start from 0. So first index is your 0. So if I have the prefixes 1, 2, 3, 4 with the segment index number 65, so this is going to be add 65 from the base label, which is the starting from 16,000, like that. Okay, so this is the now allocation flow is given. Notice in this case, let's say here, this router is, for example, that router is using label for this prefix 1.1.1.1. So this is the prefix is advertised by this provider edge. Maybe this is provider edge 2. So which means since I'm going to be use the index 1 for this index 1. So here this is advertising that label, which means this router also knows that label for this 111 is 16,001. This router is also knows that label for the same prefix is 16,001. And then of course this is also knows label for that destination prefix 111 is 16,001. Which means now, say there is a packet is coming from source address is 4.4.4, but the destination is I have 1.1.1.1. This is where once the untagged packet is arrive on that provider edge router, so this will look for that, do I have any label for this destination prefix? Which means notice, once it will confirm the routing tables, of course in the routing tables I should see that there is a label is available for this destination 111. So this is the provider edge router is going to be impose that label value 16001, and then it is going to be forward to that the next router. So next router is simply is going to be doing the swapping functionality here. So what it will do, what is, because we know that for this 111 it is the same label it is going to receive, so it is going to be receiving the packet from 4 and going to be replaced with the same outgoing label is 16001. And then this router save this. Notice this router here is the last, second last router from the egress. Notice in this case, router which is originally sending update, that is also known as ingress. Sorry, egress. So this is my second last router from the egress. So in the MPLS concept, second last router is also known as PHP router. So that functionality is also retained here, which means once packet is, I mean the label packet is arrive on this PHP router, this will see that in the forwarding table, next hop is pointing to that POP label, which means this router when it is giving instructions to that next router, this will says that whenever you are going to be send traffic to this destination 111, so then remove the label, POP meaning remove the label, so that I will check only one table, which is my routing table, or essentially your FIB table, and then forward my packet outside from the MPLS cloud. Okay, so here, so right now, in this case, packet is untagged, packet is arrive on this provider edge 1, and provider is, this is not his payload, and that is going to be push this label 16,001 for this destination prefix 111. Same bias, notice this router, once it is receiving it, so because for this destination 111, all router is using the same label, so that label, outer label remain the same. Same logic is applicable in next router as well. So once the this label packet arrive on this PHP router, this is going to be remove the label, and then simply sending the untag, the POP based label to that final provider edge router. And this is where the provider edge is going to be forward this packet to outside from the MPLS cloud. So this is my segment routing concept, where we have a global label, which is globally unique. And the second one is your adjacency label, which is automatically generated from the range starting from 24,000. So now notice the way we can recognize that what set of label is used in that particular platform. So this is a snapshot is taken from the iOS XR router. We have noticed this is the commands we can use. So in these examples, there is default label value is not changed. So notice we can see that start label is 16,000, where the size for that label range is 8,000. So total range we have, notice starting from 16,000 to 23,999. So that we can, of course, verify with these commands, show MPLS label table range. Once we confirm that, this is the example is given that how I can enable segment routing. Notice if I'm using the ISIS protocols, so then there is a prerequisite. We use this metric style wide with ISIS, because by default ISIS is using the narrow style metric, which is not a scalable solutions, and the technologies like traffic engineering, segment routing do not support that narrow style, which means metric style wide is the prerequisite. And then in order to enable, notice segment routing, so we have this one line commands, segment routing, and then of course my forwarding plane is MPLS. So with this commands, MPLS is going to be enabled on all my interfaces except those which is configured with passive. So passive ID is the same, when we have, notice here, loopback interface. So because I know that this is not going to make a session with anyone for the security reasons, I can, or do not send that hello packets, I can make this passive, which means MPLS forwarding is going to be enabled on all my non-passive interface with this one line commands inside your ISIS process. Notice adjacency segment ID, which is your automatically generated and locally significant on that link, that are again allocated and distributed for all adjacency. And of course, later on we will see that applications like traffic engineering, which is traditionally we are implementing with the help of RSVP, the same thing we can also implement with the help of segment routing. So this is the next example is given. Notice the complete examples where how I can configure the segment routing in that iOS or XR box. Notice first we are starting the process, and then here we are enabling the address family for IPv4. Then of course a metric style wide is the prerequisite for this, and then I'm going to enable a segment routing MPLS for all my interfaces except the interface which is configured with this passive commands. Notice passive meaning it is not going to be make a neighborship. So now in order to enable that segment routing, I mean, notice this is my loopback interface. So of course we are using that loopback interface in order to configure global label. So this is the commands. Notice here under the address family we are using this prefix segment ID. We can set absolute value here, but we can also set index as well. So in this case index, if I'm going to be set 1, so that have the same meaning, which is we are setting like using this absolute approach. So this is the idea where how I can use or enable segment routing with this simple commands. Now notice in order to remove that additional overhead for that deselection process, it is recommended use your transit link, I mean core facing link, with that point-to-point configurations. And then on this is my physical interface. Notice in this case we are going to enable both family IPv4 and IPv6. But this is we have seen how simple it is to enable that segment routing. There is no extra signaling protocol is required. So features of that MPLS forwarding we are embedding and within this IGP based protocols. And we know that we have only two choices. Either we can use ISIS or we can use OSPF. Now, once we have enabled, so this is the commands we can use to verify, show ISS database. Notice here we can see that there is segment routing is enabled for both topologies, IPv4 and IPv6, where following bits are also there, where we can also see the range here, 16,000, total range is 8,000. And then, of course, values, meaning for those values here, S0, when the S bit is 0, so this means this is not going to be propagate TLB to other level. So in ISIS, we are going to be used and that level 2, level 1. We are in the service provider segments, of course, ideally use that level 2, which is the most recommended approach. Okay, so further we can see the meaning for all this. Notice segment routing with this capabilities I1 meaning. This I1 meaning we have IPv4 is enabled, and once this V with 1 is activated, which means IP version 6 is also enabled. So these are the commands we can use that how my segment routing is becoming actionful using these verification commands. Further, we can see here show ISIS database verbose commands and following outputs we can see. So this is examples for ISIS. Similarly, the same logic we can apply for the next type of protocol, that is we have OSPF. So now all this command is focused on about how we can verify once segment routing is enabled on that each router. So make a point, all the router in my MPLS cloud must going to be enabled this segment routing, because ultimately we are providing that label forwarding logic. Okay, so next one, notice this is the example is given for OSPF routing, where notice in case of OSPF we have to be enabled two commands. Like earlier we have seen in ISIS there is one line command segment routing MPLS, but here two command is required when I using OSPF, segment routing MPLS and then the segment routing forwarding MPLS. Once I do this, so now so same thing is going to be happens like twice we have seen in ISIS. So once, so this is the commands we need to be apply on all the routers in my MPLS cloud. And then notice the way I'm going to be, this is the here, the examples where I can enable the segment routing for area wise as well. So segment routing MPLS and segment routing forwarding MPLS. So this one is examples if I want to disable on a particular link. So how I can disable, because on area wise, all of the interface which is participating in area 0 on their segment routing is enabled, and examples for how I can disable for a particular interface. For example, link which is facing towards your customer side, there I want to and disable that this segment routing with that forwarding capability. So the way I can set, notice this is once again is giving examples here. The moment I start the OSPF process, of course router ID is recommended approach, then I'm going to be enabled. Notice here when I using the segment routing, these commands outside from the area, so this is going to be applicable for all area, which means simply I will go for specific area 0, and then the way I'm going to be set global label, which is your prefix segment ID. So here, once again, same commands, prefix segment ID, absolute value. So here we can also set index number, and then index is 1 like this. So once again, notice a network type is point to point, which is recommended. That is going to be remove my additional overhead that is associated in OSPF in terms of LSA. Okay, so once I enable, so these are the commands is on all the routers, and make sure notice because global label we are configuring manually. So make sure that in all routers, this value must be unique. So simple approach is that we can use the prefix, segment ID, and set indexes. So index 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. So this is the only requirements. As long as this global value is, this global label is unique, that is the only requirements to simplify that troubleshooting and verification task. So once, this command is enabled, so then I can verify using this OSPF database commands, where the way the OSPF is going to be advertised, this is using opac LSA. So this is examples for your opac LSA with that type 10, and that is going to be advertised this segment routing informations. So next feature with the segment routing is that, of course, once I enable my segment routing, I also want link protection as well as node protection. And for that purpose, in order to protect my link and node, of course, segment routing is using topology independent loop free alternate mechanisms, where idea is that quick convergence I want if any my primary link is failed. And of course, notice this is simple to operate and understand, automatically computed by IGP. And of course, this is also we are using to protecting LDP, although not required. And of course, specifically for IP traffic, which means, say I have, this is my router one and router number two here, like this. So router one is connecting with my source here, source, and this is connected with my destination machine. So in these examples, I want to make sure this is my primary link, or maybe high speed link, 10 gig link. But then at the same time, let's say we have topologies like this, router number three, we have router number four as well. There is router number five like this, and then connecting back to here. So notice in this case, from source to destinations, this is the, of course, optimum link. So that is the link, which is my primary link here. That is my primary link. So I want to make sure that if this link is, of course, failed, then I quickly able to converge via the alternate path through this way. At the same time, we need to be make sure that our once I sending the packet from one router to another. So of course, each router is looking for its own view, and then making sure that this router, in order to provide that loop-free topology, so router three should not able to, so say here, if this link is down, so router one is need to be find alternate path, but at the same time, when it is forwarding this traffic to router number three, so this loop-free alternate is making sure that this packet is not looping back, because if the packet is looping back, so then it is not going to be reached to final destinations. So that kind of benefits we are providing with the help of this topology independent loop free alternate concept. So quick reconvergence, and then this is providing, of course, link and node protections. Then additional capabilities we have. So with segment routing, that is your segment routing traffic engineering. Notice traffic engineering concept is again same like we are using earlier with using the protocol RSVP. But once again, there is no requirement of RSVP, but all that capabilities which is we are getting from RSVP, that is we are again, we are getting with this segment routing concepts. So the first, in order to take the advantage of this segment routing traffic engineering, so nodes in the network must be using, of course, segment routing must be enabled. So that is a prerequisite for segment routing traffic engineering. And then in order to find the path, this is again the terminology, we have head end routers and tail end router. Which means head end router is giving instructions about which path it is going to be take, most optimum path with all that features, which is we are getting using that RSVP. Notice it is the headend routers require all that database, and that again complete database we are providing with the help of that ISIs or that OSPF protocols. So one simple command, notice this is the commands in order to activate, in order to distribute all the additional informations which is be required to take the advantage of this TE. So this is the configuration is only required on your headend router. And remember, headend router is your provider edge router. On that provider edge routers, we are going to be apply this commands. Notice the if I'm using ISIs, so same command, distribute link state. And if I'm using the OSPF, then the same commands, distribute link state. Remember, there is no requirements. When I'm saying MPLS, which means there is no LDP, there is no RSVP required in order to, and again, there is no tunnel-based mechanisms, which is we are, tunnel is introducing again the additional overhead in case of RSVP. So there is no tunnel-based concept we are using in order to fulfill that traffic engineering logic. So these are the benefits we are taking from this segment routing. So outcome of this webinar is that segment routing is the advanced version of MPLS. We are not replacing the MPLS technology. We want that, of course, label forwarding logic, but then at the same time, we don't want to add additional control plane overhead. That is the problems we are solving with this segment routing concepts. So this is the commands. Notice here, once the segment routing is enabled, we can verify that here. Even though this is saying that traffic engineering is enabled on a tunnels, but there is specific tunnel interface is not required to configure or giving instructions that which path I want to take. Either I want to select the dynamic path or I want to take the explicit path. So that is, of course, in order to give that information, there is a specific tunnel interface is not required. Okay, so finally, we can also verify that, notice this is a commands, if the segment routing is enabled or not. So that is the commands we can use where, in this case, again, ISIS protocol is we are using to distribute all the link informations, bandwidth, of course, reserve bandwidth, all that informations, which is earlier we are going to be exchange traditionally using, of course, the same protocols we are using, but for the signaling, we are using RSVP, but then there is no requirement of RSVP. Okay, so this is about this segment routing webinar concept. So quick verifications with the help of topology as well. So in this examples, I'm using this simple topology where notice we have these are in this case router 1 to router 4. These are my provider edge routers where this router 4 is configured with prefix 444. So just take the quick idea that how I configure that segment routing using this ISIS as a control plane protocols, which means notice if I go for running configurations, and then in the running configurations, notice here I'm using the ISIS protocols, and here I have enabled segment routing with MPLS flag. Again, this is recommended. Metric style wide is required, and the way I'm going to be set global label, notice on that loopback interface, we are going to be set prefix segment ID index 4, which means here if I look for show MPLS label table range or that table commands, notice we are using this ISIS for advertising this label informations. That means this is the prefixes advertised by router 4, and if I go to router number 3 here. This is my P router, and for this prefix, this will be your PHP router. Notice if I look for show MPLS forwarding here, and if I see that label, this is your label which is advertised by router 4 in this case. And notice your outgoing label is POP label. So same logic, like we have the MPLS forwarding logic using LDP. But here, if I look for show IP or show route, notice because there is no signaling, additional signaling protocol we are using. So show IP route IPv4 and prefix number, which is we have 444. If I see the detailed information for that, so here, here I can see, notice there is a label, that one is your 16004 for that prefix, and the similar information if I see with the help of Ceph table, 444 and then detail. So here I can see that, notice a local, this is your local adjacency, local label is 16004, and then that is advertised by Nextop router using this label. Label imposed by the provider edge router is implicit null, which means if I go for next router, which is my router number 2 here, and look for the prefix, that same prefix of show root, notice I'm looking for that root number which is advertised by 444. I will see that all the routers, so detailed commands for this. Here we can see that this is labeled segment routing, and then here I can see local label, which is also 16004. So finally, if I look for forwarding table in my provider edge 1, in this case router 1, so here show MPLS forwarding table, and notice this is the label, right? 16004 local label is also same, and outgoing label, which is I'm getting from this next stop 12.2. The way I can see that what this label is assigned for which prefix, so show of course root, we have in this case root number is 444 and detail informations. So that is the label is assigned for, notice label number is 16004, which means if I go for trace route 44444, so here I can see that, notice this is the P1 router is using same label, that is my PHP router, that is of course removing the label, and final router is only getting that untag a label which is using the functionality like POP. So here, of course, the benefit of the MPLS technology is to make your service provider technology free from BGP prefixes. If I see the routing table here, show root, and if I look for the prefix number 5.5.5, notice this prefix is not available. But then if I go for my customer, in this case, this router 55 and 60, these are my customer edge routers. So from here, if I going to be trace route to that 666 from here, so still notice I can forward traffic to that final destination 666 sourcing from 555, where this router is learning that 666 using that BGP prefixes. So that is the, of course, the informations about segment routing. So I hope this webinar is providing useful informations to you guys. So if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. So anyone having any questions, so feel free to ask. So this is all about this webinar. So outcome of this webinar is to understand about what is overall segment routing concept. So simple meaning, I don't want LDP overhead, I don't want RSVP overhead, but then of course same level forwarding functionality is we required because there is no such replacement for that technology yet, level forwarding technology. So the same technique we are getting with the help of this segment routing. So with this information, thank you very much for attending this webinar. In the chat box, there is a feedback link is also pasted. So of course, also fill that feedback form set how this webinar is going to be useful for you. So there's one question regarding limitations about segment routing. So this is the limitations about segment routing you're talking about. So see, there is regarding the limitation, that is your, again, hardware and of course, the software based specific questions. If your hardware is so robust, so there is no such limitation we're going to be get because the Cisco is providing the robust hardware for that. There is limitation and scalability, of course, that is, of course, platform specific informations. Notice segment routing we are using to remove the challenges which is we are facing with the existing technologies. So the limitations which is we are getting from the existing technologies, that is we are going to be removed with this segment routing concepts. All right, so thank you very much once again. With that information, I'm going to be wrap up this webinar. Thank you very much. Yeah, so there is no other protocols. Notice there is in MPLS, traditionally we are using LDP and RSVP, right? And then there is a MPBGP, which is we are going to be used on edge routers. MPBGP is still there, but then we are not using LDP and RSVP. Instead of that, the segment label functionality is inserted in that ISIS, OSPF, and BGP protocols, which means MPLS is the same label forwarding, but then there is no LDP and RSVP. Yes, so segment routing is the answer of all that additional protocols, which is we are using to populate our, to build our label table like that. So there is no replacement of MPLS yet. Yes. So we are solving that control plane overhead by removing the that LDP and RSVP from the service provider core network like that. Okay, so take care. See you and bye-bye.